With their wild songs, revealing at once the highest joy and the deepest sadness, consulting neither time nor tune, I have sometimes thought that the mere hearing of those songs would do more to impress some minds with the horrible character of slavery than the reading of whole volumes of philosophy on the subject could do. They breathe the prayer and complaints of souls boiling over with the bitterest anguish. Every tone was a testimony against slavery and a prayer to God for deliverance from chains. The songs represents the sorrows of heart, reliven by them only as an aching heart. At least such is my experience. The singing of a man cast away upon a desolate island might be as appropriately considered as evidence of contentment and happiness. I have never heard any songs like those anywhere since I left slavery, except when in Ireland. There, I heard the same wailing notes and was much affected by them. They speak to the heart and to the soul of the thoughtful. They dance and sing and make all manner of joyful noises. So they do. But it is a great mistake to suppose them happy because they sing. Such is the constitution of the human mind, that when pressed to extremes, it often avails itself of the most opposite methods. Extremes meet in mind as in matter.